Creative burnout is so real, and at every level, that's really when you are in a state of physical, mental, and emotional fatigue. Like, you're tired everywhere. And it's almost like you have given everything and you have nothing more to give. And you're creatively, you're actually depleted because your energy is depleted. Your creative juices are depleted. So in that moment, sometimes it could feel as though you're not creative anymore, or you can be experiencing blocks, or it can be like, you know what, you're not having fun or you're having joy. You know, there was a time I think I shot almost back to back, and I was like, if anybody gives me a camera right now, I will throw it at you. Because I was just exhausted. And it's important to pay attention to this, right? Burnouts, because if not taken care of, it can lead to many more things. It can lead to complete disinterest in your work, decline in customer satisfaction. It can just lead to you dialing in. You know, you get to the point, you're not applying any passion or creative. You're just like, you know what, let's just get this thing going. How do you know that you're burnt out or maybe experiencing some of these things and you don't know exactly what it is and you know what you're experiencing? Some of the indications of burnout is, first of all, physical exhaustion. You're physically tired, you're mentally tired, you're emotionally tired, right? You have been working, and this usually comes from when you're working back to back to back and you haven't taken some time out and you have just been on the roll, right? And you get to that point where it's almost like, I can't give anything anymore. That is already an indication that you're burnt out. Another one is if you're easily irritable, that's the truth. If you've been working consistently and you're easily irritable, the slightest thing would throw you out or would irritate you or would make you flare up, you know, for no reason. Like, the things that you should not flare up naturally for is an indication that burnout is knocking or is there already. So I've talked about, first of all, physical, mental, and emotional exhaustion. Second one, being irritable. Third one is lack of motivation. You just don't have any motivation for anything. You're not gingered. There's no ginger for any work. Things that used to excite you before, they don't excite you that much. You get a job and it should excite you, but it doesn't really excite you as it normally should. It's already an indication that you are burnt out. You're struggling with a lot of self-doubt. I mean, you're celebrated outside, but when you go in, there's just so much doubt and there's just so much worry and concern about the future, how things are going to be for you and all of those things. That feeling of still not being that good enough, you're struggling a lot with that. It's also an indication that you are burnt out. Another indication is procrastination. So if you find yourself that you're constantly procrastinating work, right? You have a deadline looming and you're constantly like, I'll do it tomorrow. You're not motivated. You're not excited. You don't want to get it done, right? So once you find yourself constantly procrastinating, it's already an indication that, you know what, you're probably burnt out. As creatives, we would always get to this point because the work that we do, it takes heart and soul. Most times, we give our everything. Whatever it is that you're doing with your hands or as a creative, you're dealing with everything. So you give everything. So it means that every now and then, you're going to experience it. We all would experience it. I have experienced it so many times and I still experience it. Take a break. That's the first thing. Now, it sounds counterintuitive. No, you know, but I have all this work to do. Why do I need to take a break? If you don't take a break, you're actually putting in so much time and doing little. That's because you're exhausted. So if you take all that time and say, you know what, I'm shutting down my computer, I am not doing any editing today, I'm going to take this day for myself and I'm going to do something completely unrelated to my craft or unrelated to my creative pursuit, that would make a world of difference. Because what you're doing now is you're refueling yourself. So take a break, go and do something else, go to the beach, take yourself out, go and hang out with your friends, travel, explore a new location. The second one is find inspiration. Sometimes you are so stuck looking at the same thing. Try looking at other things. Go and look at artwork, paintings, architectural work. Find inspirations in the unconventional things that you're not normally used to. Expose yourself to new environments that sparks up this creativity in you. When burnout comes, it comes with creative block, because at that point it's almost like I can't do anything else. Go and watch movies, right? When you watch movies, look at it from a different way. It just sparks something in you, right? And it just sort of refuels that creativity and inspires you even more. Sometimes burnout can be as a result of just being overwhelmed with so much that you have to do. Maybe you're in that place where you have this big project, or you have this big goal, you know, there's just so much you have to do. There's a lot on your table. And then that can create overwhelm, and that can create burnout, and that can just create, you know, lack of motivation. Set a bit more realistic goals. See how you can break these big tasks into smaller goals and smaller achievable goals. You have this big thing that you want to do, right? First of all, figure out how much time do you have and what are the things that you have to do with that time. Now break those things into maybe monthly or weekly and daily. You'll find that once you break a big task into smaller achievable goals, you just feel that ease and it makes it easier for you to get things done. And the last one would be two things just for the fun of it. Sometimes we take ourselves too seriously. If you're a photographer and you've constantly been doing client work, go and shoot for fun. Go and shoot plants, birds. Go and shoot the sky. Go and shoot trees. Just go and shoot something that is completely unrelated, just for the fun and for the love of the art. Remember, your work comes from the inside out. If you're not filled on the inside, if you don't refill, you will not be able to pour, because you can't pour from an empty cup. Once your cup is empty, it is your responsibility to do what you need to do to fill it, so that you have enough to still give.